Hey guys, it's Aysel from Vectorator. Let's draw this cool snake illustration slash idea for your next tattoo today. I used auto trace for this one, which helped me achieve this super cool vector texture that would otherwise take me ages to create. So let's see how I did it. I first sketched this out in Procreate. And now all I'm doing is selecting the image, going to auto trace from quick actions, make sure it's on sketch mode, and then I turn up the contrast. I experimented a bit before, depending on the sketch, it's always going to be a different result. Let's do the same for the flowers. Sketch mode is on, contrast is up, and done. And now everything you see here is vector shaped that I can play around with. So let's play around. Let's color the snake in this nice pink gradient. Then I'm going to create a background. This actually looks super nice, but let's change it to an orange gradient. The way you can create gradients is by tapping the gradient button in the color picker, and then by tapping again on each of these two teardrops, on the left and on the right, and select each color separately. At this point, I need to make sure that I place all my layers in the correct order, so the snake should be at the top. Okay, now I want to retrace my entire snake because I want to give it a more prominent outline. While my auto-trace snake does have an outline, it's grouped together with the texture. And honestly, this is the fastest way to achieve the result I want. If you like the outline to be delicate like it is now, feel free to skip this step. Let's lower the opacity because it's time to focus on refining our paths. So pick up the node tool and tweak any anchor points that need adjusting. Alright, let's do the same for our entire snake. About this white spot you see here, it's supposed to be a negative space. So let's give it the same color as the background. Let's make sure the snake pattern is on the very top. Zooming in, you can see just how cool the texture is. I really love using auto trace for this. I want my black outline to be even more prominent. So I'm duplicating my snake shape, switching fill off, and then I'm moving the outline on the top of the snake texture. Working with the groups and layers really helps here. Okay, let's move on to the flowers. I'm individually selecting all the shapes that form my flower with multi-select mode turned on. As you can see, there are a lot of paths that were generated from auto trace operation. And then I color them purple. If you've missed a few, just repeat this until all your petals are purple. Orange and purple oppose each other on the color wheel, so they make for a great palette. And I honestly tend to use purple a lot of the time. I'm making the center of the flower black. Again, multi-select mode is on. And the leaves I'm coloring green, another one of my go-to shades. Let's do the same on the other side. Use multi-select, go to color widget, pick the hue, and that's it. I want these elements that go around my snake to be dark purple instead of pure black. It was too much contrast with just black. And finally, let's clean up any areas that we've missed. And I think with that, we're finished with our illustration. It's probably one of my favorites that I've done so far. What do you guys think? Let us know in the comments below. Also below, you can download the Vectorator file, which includes the sketch, so you can start creating right away. So have fun, like and subscribe, and I'll see you soon.